We're going to send as many trips as we need to get the mission done.
So no numbers.
No numbers. And just really quickly, just to be clear, the reason is because it's a partnership with the governors. It's not us telling them and sending the guard.
Right.
So we're going back and forth right now. This is how we think we can supplement the Border Patrol. And then, of course, we look for the good advice of governors who are on the front lines.
Are all the governors cooperating in this?
I've talked to all four, had good conversations with all four. The conversations will continue.
Is it true that they'll be unarmed?
I did talk to Governor Brown. We had an initial conversation. I hope to talk to him again today. He has seen this happen before, and he has seen it happen well. You know, the whole concept here is to first multiply the Border Patrol, so the Border Patrol can do Border Patrol work. I'm hopeful that I'll continue to talk to him and see what we can work out. Mm-hmm. So overall, historically, last year, the numbers were down. We did see, and we called that the Trump effect, as you know, in the sense that he was so clear, so dedicated, so pointed on this topic during the campaign and early days of the administration. People didn't want to come. They didn't want to risk it. Once they've realized that they can get in and they can stay because of the loopholes and because of the backlog, the numbers have gone back up. We could also say it's because of our economy. You know, we hear a lot of people wanting to come here for economic opportunities. But for whatever reason, all of the numbers are going up. Our numbers last month were a 200% increase from that same time last year. So we had 30,000 come across our border that we interdicted or were inadmissible. So we are at a crisis point. We'd like to stop it before the numbers get even bigger.